What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Sundays with Sally. We are back aboard my project boat here, getting a few more items checked off the to-do list. And what I wanted to go over today was TZ's IBoat app. Now, there's a lot of marine navigation apps that are out there that are available to you. I want to show you guys TZ IBoat one here. It's pretty slick. It's got integrated weather. It has built-in base maps, all free, no charge. If you want to have raster or vector charts, you can get those on here. Download them. It is an additional fee. If you want additional weather, you can also download that. So I've got it up over here on my iPad, on my handy-dandy rock mount here. So I'm going to go kind of walk you guys through some of the features and why this might be worth something to look into. As with everything when it comes to these iPads, they do have built-in GPS into the iPad, but they work a lot better if you get a plug-in external GPS antenna, or if you sync it to one of your MFDs if it has Wi-Fi and that functionality to it. So, with that caveat out of the way, let's go ahead, let's pull this out of here, and let's go ahead and we'll load it up. So, we go in, we have the TZ IBoat app, and as we go ahead and it opens up here, boom, shows us right where we are. We have our base maps right here, and in our lower right-hand corner, we see the little hamburger there of the three stacked squares. Bring that up, and you see we have basic maps, we have our raster charts, we have our vector charts, we have satellite overlay. But if we scroll down a little bit, you'll see that we also have wind, waves, air temp, clouds, current. We can, you know, see what the precipitation's doing, what the wind's doing. We can check tidal stations, you know, everything right there. If you are familiar with the Furuno world of chart plotters, this is all going to be really familiar to you. Like I said, these are all the built-in features into it. If we want to come onto here and we want to see what the wind is doing, it's as simple as just pressing that wind icon. And you can see here, we got about 15 knots of breeze. I can go ahead and zoom out and I can kind of get a good view of what's going on. And if I want to, I can scroll this forward and back and see what my weather is going to be doing. You know, there we are. Now we're looking at tomorrow. It's very simple, very clean, very easy to use, all free. Now we come into here and I say, you know what? I want to see, let's see what the waves are going to do tomorrow. And again, it's going to take a second. As long as there's Wi-Fi connected to this, you're going to get this data. So now I can come into here and I can look and see, what are the waves going to be doing? Are they building or are they not building? So we can go into here and we can look and see what the waves are looking like. So we have all of these features built into it. And then we can come in and we want to change and we want to see what the air temperature is doing, right? There we go. It's very simple to just go ahead and update and move these things around. And again, these are all free and included with the app. So if I want to see, you know, maybe there's going to be some rain or some cloud coming, I can do this. And now I've got my wind tails on there. And I can zoom out and I can kind of see where the cloud cover is. And I can look and see, you know what, looks like there's some rain up to the north of me that might be coming this way. And as I advance this forward, I can see, is that coming or is that just going to break up? So, again, really slick, really handy, all for free, right? So then we can come over here. We go into our raster charts, which everybody's fairly familiar with, right? And now I can come into here and look at just how quickly this moves around, how much it zooms in. It's very quick, very easy to use, very nice, very seamless. Great. You can set and build your routes. It will save them on there for you. If you want to go in and do a ruler, you know, to measure distances for things, if you want to actually just build a route, put your finger on there and say, okay, let's build a route. And now we're going to do a new route, and we go from there. That's our first leg. Let's just say our second leg is going to be, let's go down here somewhere off of Cape Ann, and we want to go here, and we want to go here, and we want to go here. Just that simple to build a route. It's really straightforward, easy to use. Like I said, if you are familiar with the Furuno world of things, this is going to be kind of come second nature to you. So it's definitely a worthwhile app to check out. So that's it. That's TZ IBoat. It is in the App Store for Apple and Android. And Yeah, it's something worth checking out. It's another option out there. A lot of horsepower built into this one, and I think the really nice feature with this one is the ability to have the weather overlay onto that. So even if you have a great chart plotter, but maybe you didn't spring for the Sirius XM weather, but you do have Wi-Fi, your phone's hooked into it or whatever, now you can pull up the weather forecast and you can download it ahead of time before you leave for the next, you know, 2 days, 48 to 72 hours. You can get all that weather downloaded onto there and have a really good idea of what's coming. So, and then if you are still in cell range, you can connect back up and resync and get all that data out there. So it's pretty slick. Definitely worth checking out, guys. So that's it. That's what I got for you guys today. As always, be sure to give us a follow on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook at Navtronics. And we got a couple more things up our sleeves here to be working on. And hopefully we're filling that itch for you guys since all these boat shows this fall are being canceled and trying to keep you guys up to date with the latest marine tech trends. So until next time, I'm going to hang out on my boat here and figure out what else we got going on and go from there, I guess.